Good evening, all. Myself, Dr. Partha Verma, final year radiology resident from Usmania Medical College. First, I would like to thank CT Bus for this opportunity. Today, I am going to present CT cystography evaluation of urinary bladder trauma. Introduction: urinary bladder injury may result from either blunt or penetrating trauma. The propensity for bladder injury is related to degree of bladder distension at the time of impact. Associated injuries may lead to mortality rate as high as 44%. Bladder injuries may be extraperitoneal, intraperitoneal, or combined. Traditionally, bladder injuries often have been evaluated with dedicated conventional cystography. Cytocystography has replaced conventional cystography as it allows multi-panel reconstructions to identify the site of rupture, differentiating between intraperitoneal and extraperitoneal rupture, and a complete study of abdominopelvic region in patients with abdominal trauma. Aims and objectives of my study are to identify anatomical spaces related to bladder and to describe the imaging features of bladder injury in CT cystography. Materials and methods: all patients with suspicion of bladder trauma presented to Usmania General Hospital. CT cystography was done in Hitachi 128 slice CT. Suspicion of bladder trauma, such as conventional CT findings of pelvic fractures, hematuria after trauma, mechanism of trauma that leads to a high suspicion of bladder trauma, they were referred to CT cystography. Technique is preliminary CT pelvis for fractures and all, and then preparation of 500 ml of diluted contrast solution, installation of 350 to 400 ml of contrast solution under gravity through the Foley's catheter, clamp the catheter to maintain adequate bladder distension, and then post-contrast CT pelvis. Observation and results: this pie chart showing distribution of cases with suspected bladder injury. In that, on CT cystography of 18 patients, 7 patients had bladder injury and 11 patients had no bladder injury. This is the gender-wise distribution of bladder trauma cases, in which 7 out of 7 cases, 5 are males, 2 are females. Type of bladder trauma: 5 are intraperitoneal bladder trauma and 2 are extraperitoneal. Come to the anatomy. Here is the image showing normal male pelvis and female pelvis. The spaces are related to urinary bladder as perivesical space that surrounds and contain urinary bladder, rectovesical space, and an intraperitoneal space between urinary bladder and rectum, presacral space, prevesical space, or space of Ridges, is an extraperitoneal space located posterior to the pubic symphysis and anterior to the urinary bladder, and rectouterine pouch or pouch of Douglas. This is extension of peritoneum between the rectum and posterior wall of the uterus, which is analogous to rectovesical pouch in males. And then come to the cases. Case 1 is a complex extraperitoneal rupture. Image 1 and 2 are the axial images of CT cystogram showing streaky extravasated contrast noted in false facial planes of bladder with tracking of contrast noted along the anterior abdominal wall, bilateral inguinal canal, andromedial aspect of left thigh, gluteal region, which indicate complex extraperitoneal rupture of the bladder. Case 2, extraperitoneal rupture of bladder. Figure 3, axial images of CT cystography showing contrast extravasation in retropubic region, which indicate extraperitoneal bladder rupture. Image 4 is axial section with bone window showing fracture of left inferior pubic ramus. Case 3, axial and coronal CT images of showing extravasated contrast material outlines the bowel loops and perihepatic region in the intraperitoneal cavity, suggest of intraperitoneal bladder rupture. Case 4. Cytocystogram demonstrates classical appearance of an intraperitoneal rupture, which is extravasated contrast material between the bowel loops and in the subhepatic region, as shown by the arrows. And then case 5, the coronal image of cytocystography showing extravasated contrast material between the bowel loops of peritoneum in pelvis, suggest of intraperitoneal rupture. Come to the discussion. Radiologist should be familiar with anatomical spaces and structures in order to make a good approach to bladder injuries. Spaces surrounding bladder are prevesical space, rectovesical pouch, rectouterine space, and presacral prevesical spaces. CT cystography have been advocated in lieu of conventional cystography in initial workup of patient with suspected bladder trauma. CT cystography was applied to classification scheme for bladder injury based on degree of wall injury and anatomical location and demonstrated characteristic imaging features for each type of injury. Bladder injury can be classified into contusion, interstitial injury, and rupture. Abbott et al. Stated that 60 to 90% of patients with bladder injuries caused by blunt trauma have associated with pelvic fracture, and 44% of patients with bladder injuries have at least one or other intra-abdominal injury. In current study, most common associated injury with bladder trauma was pelvic fractures. The most commonly observed type of pelvic fracture in our study were unilateral pubic rami fractures and fractures of pubic bones. Conventional cystography has long been considered as a standard reference for evaluating patients with suspected bladder injury, as increased diagnostic accuracy and characterization of injuries on CT cystography, it is replaced radiography in many trauma centers. Coming to types of bladder trauma, type 1 is bladder contusion, which is an incomplete or partial tear of bladder mucosa. CT findings usually normal. Type 2 is intraperitoneal rupture. CT cystography demonstrates intraperitoneal contrast material around the bowel loops and between the mesenteric folds and in the paracolic gutters. Type 3 is interstitial bladder injury, which manifestations include intramural hemorrhage, submucosal extravasation of contrast material without transmural extension. Type 4 is extraperitoneal rupture, which is further classified into simple and complex. Simple includes extravasated contrast material is limited to perivesical spaces. Complex is contrast solution extends further into abdominal wall, perineum, scrotum, and dissect the facial planes and spaces. Type 5 is combined intra and extraperitoneal rupture, usually demonstrate extravasation patterns that are typical for both types of injury. This is a classification system for bladder injury based on findings on CT cystography. As we discussed, type 1 is bladder contusion, 2 is intraperitoneal rupture, 3 is interstitial bladder injury, 4 is extraperitoneal rupture, 4A is simple extraperitoneal, 4B is complex extraperitoneal rupture, 5 is combined type of bladder injury. Come to the conclusion, CT cystography provides experienced evaluation of urinary bladder injuries with high degree of sensitivity and specificity. Urinary bladder injuries have characteristic CT cystography features that can be used for accurate classification and better treatment planning. The CT cystography does not only aid the diagnosis of urinary bladder injuries, but also decisive role in surgical procedures. In patients with suspected bladder injury due to trauma, CT cystography should be done even if the initial findings of non-contrast CT are negative. These are my references. Thank you. I would like to thank my HOD, my professors,